This week, racing games. Show them the car for illustration. So you've got a picture of a... Historians generally agree that racing game genre is the oldest genre in games.
The first recorded racing game was Race to Rhodesia in 1936, which was released on the ZX Spectrum.
Race to Rhodesia was a success, outselling every film, book, and parlor game between 1937 and 1939. Although by today's standards the graphics were simple, gamers were so shaken by the realistic high speeds of Cornelius's penny farthing that they vomited on their controllers, and many contracted tuberculosis.
But between 1939 and 1945, the driving game industry suffered a slump, with many players preferring to go abroad to go and kill each other.
Then in 1946, the genre took off again. Governments realized that the addictiveness of racing games made them a handy tool for propaganda. Who can forget Space Race 1969, a simulated jet battle between the Americans and the Russians? Then Tiananmen Square on the NES, and in Britain, Miners Strike Rally, in which drivers from northern pit towns competed for the quickest time to run over Margaret Thatcher. In 1992, the UN passed a resolution forbidding any government to use computer games to further its own diabolical ideology. So developers went back to the drawing boards.
Fun arcade karting games for children. Step forward, Mario Kart. First released in France in 1992 and in the rest of the world in 1992, Mario Kart was the first go-karting game ever. And if historians tell you that there are other go-karting games released before that, then they're wrong. These family fun friendly arcade races were praised by the industry for being completely uncontroversial. But then disaster happened. Controversy struck.
Vehicles were often not roadworthy, bombs had been placed on the track, seemingly for a laugh, and if you came last in the Mushroom Cup, they made you parade the paddock in orthopedic shoes. It was...
Then, another blow. Scientists found that in the game Madagascar Karts, every time you crashed your hilarious animal racer, a real animal would die. In Africa. Developers went back to the drawing board. They needed a new genre. Within seconds, they emerged from the drawing board. A drawing board that, because drawing board technology had moved on, was now made of lasers. Why not make game versions of actual motorsports events that were going on in real life? That's what they asked.
Games were quickly made to imitate all the great motor events on the sporting calendar. These simulators went from strength to strength, with realism their selling point. Sadly, ultra-real racing sims soon became a victim of their own success. By 2007, they'd become as boring as watching the real thing.
Publishers made drastic efforts to jazz up their titles.
NASCAR 04 included the option to paint a giant phallus on your car, and Codemasters made the co-driver in Dirt 3 completely naked, and sometimes she said naughty things to you if you went really fast.
But disheartened, they admitted defeat.
It's estimated that if the current trend continues, by mid-July, there won't be a single game with cars in it left in the world. But maybe that's a good thing if we're to believe the latest rumours.
Plans have been leaked for a new dangerous genre of racing game to be released somewhere in 2012 or 2013 or 2014.
Its name? VG Racing 2 Million. Billed as the most realistic driving game ever made, containing a new type of technology called real-time wounding. Every time you have an accident in the game, you get the corresponding physical injury in real life, but only to your eyes.
It's a game that's divided opinion, even though it's literally only just been thought of. I haven't seen Skips, but maybe Skips Crisp. There you have it, iSlings. That is the future of racing games. And you just saw the past as well. We did the past before the bit of the before the ice things. That's what history is, isn't it? The past mixed with the future. So you learn from the past, and then you've got the, with quotations in between the people who've witnessed it and could forecast the future. That was history. History. Yeah.